Okay. We are just waiting for everyone to get in now. So as you guys are joining us, let us know where you're joining in from. Drop a line in the comments. And thank you guys so much for joining us today. I'm so excited to be presenting Ronnie and Veronica for this great topic on templates in both Sales Pro and Leap. So thank you again. We'll give it another minute for folks to join us. And I'm coming from Oklahoma City in Oklahoma. It is very hot here today. We have Jennifer from Connecticut. Ronnie and Veronica, where are you guys joining us from?
Yeah, so I'm here from Maryland.
And I am from New Jersey. It's also hot here.
It's almost July. We're getting to those super hot months.
Exactly.
All right. Trish is coming from Oakland, California. I'm guessing it's probably pretty warm there too. All right. We're up to 40 now. So great to see everyone in here. Got Halifax, Minnesota. Okay, in California, it's not too hot, only in the hundreds. that's how I feel in Oklahoma too. Oh, we're only in the hundreds, that's not too bad. Yorktown, Virginia, Vacaville, I'm so sorry if I butchered that, in California as well. Maryland, agreed, it's beautiful there. Fort Wayne, Indiana, we are just all over the country today, that's so exciting. Well, thank you guys. It looks like the chat's working. We are good to go. This webinar, just to give you guys a heads up, it will be recorded. We'll be sending out the recording afterwards along with some resources for you all and just recaps of the amazing things that we're learning today. So I am Melissa. I am on the product team with product marketing. And I'm not the star of the show today. I am just here to host and keep an eye on the chat and the comments. So I will turn it over now to our amazing stars of the show. We have Veronica, who has been helping contractors transform their business with Sales Pro for more than 4 years now. She started as an onboarding specialist and then spearheaded the Leap Academy. And now she's working with me on our product team to continuously improve our products based on your feedback. So thank you, Veronica, for joining us. I know you are just a treasure trove of information. And then we also have Ronnie, who has been with Job Progress since 2017, now Leap. And Ronnie made it his mission to help contractors around the country run their business more efficiently. So after the acquisition of Job Progress last year, Ronnie has continued to be a champion for contractors and now leads the onboarding team at Leap. So both of you are amazing. I always love talking to you guys. I'm glad that our customers are getting this opportunity to learn from you as well. And before we really jump into the meat of this, I think it'd be great to just sort of set the stage on why this is such an important topic. So can you both give us an idea about what it means when we say templates and why are they so important?
Sounds good. Ron, you want me to start or you want to go?
Yeah, go ahead. Get us started here.
All right. So what's up, everybody? As I like to call you guys Leapers. I know it's corny, but it sounds good in my head. So we have a couple different template options inside the Leap CRM platform. Email templates, the big idea email templates is to save you time. It's to, one, increase the communication with the customer and fast track how easily you can get that information over to them. It's two different type of ways we can use email templates, which we'll get a little bit later in the session. But the idea is just ease of use and relaying more information to your customer in a speedy process.
Love it.
To you, Veronica.
Sure. So I'll be covering templates in Sales Pro today. Templates in Sales Pro are probably one of our biggest, most favorite feature for a lot of people, because as you're going through and creating your estimates, our templates allow you to take all that information that you've added to your estimates and pull it over into your documents automatically. So no more double entry, no more errors or anything like that. Everything just gets pulled over. So one of the things I'll be showing you today is how to download templates from our template library and get them all set up.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much. And just a little bit of housekeeping before we get to the really good stuff. I will be keeping an eye on the chat in the Q&A. And at the end of the session, we will have that open and I will be asking your questions to Ronnie and Veronica. So go ahead and drop those in there as they come to you and we will get them answered at the end. All right. I will go ahead and turn it completely over to you guys now.
Oh, I'm going to start the show. So Melissa, give me a thumbs up when you guys can see my screen.
All right, we can see it.
All right. So here, guys, the first thing we're going to accomplish is successfully putting what we call a job, which you guys might know as a lead, into the Leap CRM. So there's three golden rules everybody should remember when it comes to putting a lead in. A lot of you guys might already be aware of this, but it's always nice to kind of see how it's done. So in our Leap CRM, you're going to see the plus icon in a lot of situations. That means add. So golden rule one is if you want to add a new lead to the system, you want to start with the plus button and hitting your add icon right here. The screen will load for a second. It will bring you to what we call our customer intake screen. So on the left-hand side, we have the customer information. And on our right-hand side, we have the job information. I actually always recommend hitting the add job button before you even fill out the left-hand side, because a job is one of the most important aspects of putting in a lead to make sure you have it saved inside your CRM correctly. So on the left-hand side, we're now gonna put in a customer. So I'm gonna go something like this, Ronnie Leap, last test. We're gonna put in a phone number. As you can see on the right-hand side, I've done several test customers, so the system is yelling at me to not put the same customer in more than one time. So I'm actually going to minimize this over here. And we're gonna say this is a brand new customer. We're just putting it in the system. Putting in my old email address. We do use Google Maps, so we'll pull the closest addresses to where you are. I am in New Jersey, so if I type in Walmart, the closest Walmarts to me will populate. And it would autofill everything that it can. Salesperson, we're going to use Veronica. We're going to say she's our sales rep. Preferred by is asking where the lead come from. Say Facebook. Customer note, that's an internal note describing the customer. This is nothing for the job yet. This is just for this customer, this note will always be important. They can give you 10, 15 jobs. That note will stay the same. It's an optional field. That is right here. On our right-hand side, we're now going to choose a trade. I'm going to say it's a roofing job. I could just type it in. And we're going to now choose an additional trade. So we can say if it's more than one, say it's roofing and gutters, something like this. Work types, these are different sub-trades you can associate to roofing. You can use this for reporting inside the system as you see fit. These are all customizable. So if I was doing a partial replacement and we're doing 6-inch gutters, that would work. Job description. This is a mandatory field. You can tell by the little red star here. That is description of the job. We're now just inputting the lead. We might not have too much information. So if they call you and say they just want to replace some missing shingles due to a storm, you want to come in and type this down. We're going to say the job address and our contact person is the same. So with all of this filled out, you have a save button at the top right. System would load. Save that lead. We're going to ignore this automation for now. We'll get back into this in a second. And now we have our official lead. Now we did golden rule one, which is your plus button. Golden rule two, which is your add job button. And lastly, golden rule three, which is when in doubt, plus it out. This add button pretty much gives you the ability to add anything within the job that you might need to get done. We're now going to create an appointment, which is our fourth option right here. We're now also going to say Veronica is going on that appointment. Now, if we have Sales Pro integrated with our Leap CRM, this appointment is the trigger to get that customer created in Sales Pro. Creating the job does not get that customer in Sales Pro. You need to create the job correctly and also make sure you have the appointment created correctly. Now, whoever's on the appointment, their username needs to be the same in both systems. In Leap CRM and in Sales Pro, email address does need to exactly be the same. So the system knows exactly how to push that appointment. We're going to say the appointments for today at 4 p.m. I can leave a note if I wanted to do a little bit more notes. Down here, it's asking where's the address. We're going to assume the job address. But if we're meeting at a Starbucks or somewhere else, we can just change that address. User notifications is if you want to be you as in this user here, wants to be reminded 10 minutes before the appointment via an email or 10 minutes before via push notification. When we use the word push in Leap CRM, it's going to pop up as a notification on your cellular device. So whatever device you have, the Leap CRM app. You can have more than one. I can do one 10 minutes before and one 45 minutes before. It's completely up to you. Now with our appointment done, I'm going to hit our lovely save icon. It takes a second to load itself in, but we actually can see right within here, we have an appointment that is now saved. And everyone forgets this step, but it is important. Please make sure you are moving your workflow to the proper place. So we're now taking it from lead, and we're going to say we've now assigned. Now I'm going to pass it over to Veronica so she can show you that appointment in Sales Pro and the different things you can do with that customer.
All right, thanks, Ronnie. So we are going to take a look at that appointment in just a minute here, but we're going to get into the dashboard of Sales Pro, and I'm going to show you how to download one of our templates, how to get it all set up. So that way, when we pull over that appointment into our iPad, we're going to be able to create that contract or that document and send it back to Leap automatically. All right, I'm going to go ahead and share my screen here. And everyone should be seeing the Sales Pro dashboard. So we're going to get started by heading over into our side menu here and clicking into documents. Once you're in the document section, we have our different types of documents here at the top. I'm going to be working in the contract section today. You also have the option to select from your different offices and your different states. So you can have different documents assigned to one office or another, or available in one state or another. But we're going to download a template from our template library. So I'm going to hit my Add New button. And underneath that, I have the option to choose from my Sales Pro templates. Now, starting with a template is really amazing because it saves us a ton of time of having to build our documents from scratch. And we have so many different types of templates in here for you to download, try them, customize them. We have templates for all sorts of different product verticals. So whatever you're selling, there's most likely a template in here. We also have a lot of different presentation templates too. So if you want to show them their different finance options or how long it's going to take them to see a return on their investment, we have those types of templates in here as well. Today, I'm going to use a specific one for an example. So I have a template in here called a scope of work template. And this is going to be more of a generic template that can pull over our products. But to clone this into my account, all I have to do is hit this button right here. It says copy document. And we're just going to give that a moment to clone over. All right, now that that's cloned over, I'm going to be able to find it here in my contract section. And here it is. So I'm going to choose to edit this template. So I'm hovering my mouse over the icon, and there's this little pencil icon here, and it says edit document. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And here we are. We are in our Sales Pro template, our scope of work template. Now, just a couple of things in here to note, just so that way you guys know how to navigate our template screen. Up here at the top, we have our file button. This is where you can go through and rename your document. This is where after you make changes, you'll be able to save it or even assign it to your different offices or different states. In the document itself, in our templates, we have a lot of text in here that's pre-populated. If you want to edit any of this text, all you have to do is hover your mouse over it. Once your mouse turns into a pointer finger, all you have to do is double-click on that text. And that's going to open up this little text editing box. So this is where we can go through and start to switch out that text. And I'll just click out anywhere on the screen to set that there. Another thing about our template editor that may be really important for you to know is on the right side of the screen, we have this blue button. And if I click on that, that's going to open up my cell tool drawer. This is how I can add additional line items to my document. So if I need to put more information in there, I can go ahead and grab a line item and pull it into my document. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. So if I needed to put some more text in here, I could. All right. But really, the biggest benefit of templates in Sales Pro is their ability to bring over information automatically. And the documents are really customizable. They're very flexible. Now, we're not going to have enough time today to get into all of the intricacies of our document editor and how to make them automated. But I do want to point out in our documents, you're going to see these bits of text that have percentage signs around them. These are placeholders in Sales Pro. That's what tells Sales Pro what type of information you want to pull over into your document. So here in this section, I'm going to pull over my product information. Specifically, I'm going to pull over the name of my products on the title side of the line. That's the left side of the line here. And on the right side of the line, I'm going to pull over that quantity of the products. So I'm keeping it pretty simple for today's example. So the placeholders are just one piece of making these documents automated. I actually have to tell Sales Pro what products I want to show up in this section, because if you offer multiple product verticals, you might have a different contract for your external remodeling versus maybe your bathroom remodeling. In this example, I'm going to make this document pull over my roofing products. So to do that, I'm going to select this section, and I just do that by clicking on the title of the section. And I can see that it's selected because it's got this gray drop shadow all the way around it. Now that I have this section selected, I can then head up to settings. Settings is in the top left-hand side of the menu. In our settings menu, if you look towards the bottom, we have an option called Link Measure Sheet Items. Measure Sheet Items in Sales Pro are the different products that you offer. So I'm going to click on that. And this is going to open up our linking menu. This is where I can select what items I want to pull into this section. So I'm going to start with my category. And like I said before, we're going to do roofing for this one, but I have tons of products in here. So I'm just going to scroll down and then select roofing. That's going to show me all of my roofing products. And I actually have multiple pages of roofing products in here. So where it says view rows, I'm just going to increase how many products I'm seeing on this one page here. That's going to make it a little bit easier for me. Now that I can see all of my roofing products, all I have to do is click this little checkbox up in the top left-hand corner to select all items. And this is going to make sure all of my roofing products are linked to the section. That means when I add these items to an estimate, any items I add to that estimate is going to pull over into this document. If there's an item that I don't add to my estimate, like for example, they don't need chimney flashing for whatever reason, don't worry, it's not going to show up. It's only going to show what's actually added to your estimate. So now that I have those items selected, I'm going to hit my done button and we're going to save this document. So whenever you make changes, don't forget to save. So I'm going to click on my file button and I'm going to go ahead and hit save. All right, now we are ready to jump over into the iPad. I'm going to be able to see that appointment Ronnie created for me, and we're going to use this template and bring over all of our products. So I'm going to switch my screen share. All right, so hopefully you guys can see my iPad screen. Because Ronnie has sent me a new appointment and because I've just made changes to my documents, I'm going to go ahead and refresh my iPad. To refresh, I'm clicking on this refresh button in the top left-hand corner, and that's going to sync all of the changes that I've made, and it's going to bring over any new appointments that have been assigned to me. And we'll just give that a second to load. I have a lot of products in my price guide, so sometimes it takes a minute to bring all those items in. All right, we should be done there. And underneath today's appointments, I can now see that appointment Ronnie just created for me. And all I have to do is tap on that name, And it's going to bring in that customer into Sales Pro. And it's also going to bring me to my estimating page. This is where I can start to add those different products to my estimate. So we're doing a roofing estimate. I'm going to click in roofing. I could go through and enter in all of these quantities manually, but for today's example, I'm going to use Hover because it's a lot faster. So I'm just going to pull up our test Hover report here, and I'm going to tap on that to select it. And there we go. It's filled out my quantities for my different products automatically. I'm going to hit my done button. And before I jump into my document, I'm just going to go ahead and select one of my packages here. We're going to do this Owens Corning package. All right, so now that I have my estimate ready, I have my price down here, I'm ready to use that template that I created earlier. I'm going to click into my contract section. And if I scroll down in here, I'm going to see that scope of work page that I've just created. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And you know what? Because this scope of work page is primarily bringing over the products, I'm also going to add a payment and terms page as well, just so that way I have a place to have my deposit and those other terms and conditions. So now that I have some templates selected, I can click my next button. It's going to ask me if I have these documents in the correct order. If I needed to, I could rearrange these, but this works for me. I want my scope of work first and payments and terms second. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit save. Now we're on a new screen. We're on a screen where I can go through and I can start to fill out more information. So if I needed to provide more notes, I could do that here. And down here at the bottom, I have my two pages. So this is my scope of work page. I'm going to click over to page two, which is my payment and terms. And I'm going to take a moment in here to fill in a deposit and select my form of payment. Let's say they're paying in cash for this one. All right, now that I have all my details filled out, I can click next, and this is going to generate my PDF. This is going to generate my contract. And if I'm with a customer, I can start to swipe through these different pages and talk through my different terms and conditions with them. But we're ready to sign this now. I'm going to tap anywhere on the screen, and up in the top right-hand corner, I have my option to sign. And this is going to bring up my signature fields. So this first signature field, this is for Ronnie, the test customer. So I'll go ahead and sign for him. And then I'm going to click the next button. That's going to bring me to my next signature field, which is for me, the sales rep. So I got that signed. I'm going to hit next. This template also has an initials field. So I'm going to tap with two fingers and I'm going to make sure I'm initialing that too. All right, so our contract is signed and initialed. We're ready to send it. So I'm going to tap anywhere on the screen. I'm going to hit my send button. I'm going to hit send again. It's going to ask me to confirm that Ronnie's email address is here is correct. One more time, that's going to send it off. Ronnie's going to receive a copy of his contract in his email, and it's also going to be sent to the Leap CRM automatically. So at this point, I'm going to turn this back over to Ronnie so that way he can show us what that looks like and go over some of our email templates. All right, Ronnie, you take it away.
You're muted.
I know, I was muted. I was trying to get my screen share. All right. Sounds good. So now we're inside the Leap CRM. The first thing we got to make sure we do, similar to Veronica how to do, is refresh our screen. I've been just sitting here since I moved that appointment over. So inside here, if we just refresh, I'm just going to hit F5. We're going to actually see that form populate right here. You see it went from 0 to 1. So it does pull back almost instantly. There's not a long lapse time. You are also able to control exactly which one of these fields you want that document to go. That is done on the Sales Pro dashboard. We have chosen that form comes back to forms and proposals, and we can actually see this beautiful PDF, exactly what she just showed. Now what we're going to take a look at is email templates. So with our email template feature inside Leap CRM, you can use a couple of different features to actually send out that proposal as a copy, add it to your customer webpage, a couple of different things. But first, we're going to start with the simple email templates. So right inside the job, you have a button here that says send email. This is going to default the customer's email address that you have here. I needed to send it to somebody else. I could exit and put another person in there. We're going to assume it's going to the customer. And down here, if you hover over it, it says select template. In your Leap CRM account, there are different email templates that you can use if you want to send something out. I'll show you how to build them 1 second. We're going to just take a quick look at a email template that we have. What it can do is actually auto-populate the customer's name. So it's taking the name I saved as a customer up here and actually auto-populate and dropping it into your email body and with whatever images you decide to also have with this email. Now, if I wanted to actually email the proposal, that process is still the same. I'll go to Forms and Proposals. I can hit our three dots right here. Three dots or right-clicking, it brings up the same option. And if I hit email, you're actually going to see that here's our proposal right here. If I did not like this email template, I could activate another email template over it, or I could actually change the base of this email template. This is called your system proposal template. And lastly, before we get to customization, if I decided to hit our send email icon like I did before, if I grab a template, we're going to use our estimate request one. I can actually also attach any document that's inside the job or in our company files if there's important documents there. So if we actually hit proposals, we can see that document that came back from SalesPro. And I can actually attach it here like this. Auto population, customer's name, and the salesperson assigned, as we can see. Now we're gonna take a look at email templates, how you can design some, the ones that we offer. And then from there, we'll take a look at automations. So if we hit the arrow in the top right, we have our settings icon. We're now switching from the front end of the account to the back end. We have a search icon here. So if I just type in email, it's giving me exactly the two options we have with emails. So go to templates. When you first get to email templates, you're going to have your custom library. These are the active email templates that you would like to use. This demo account has several different email templates, which each account has is a Leap library. These are all the email templates that we have offered you guys to use free of charge, as you can see here. And there are about 20 different templates. So if you want a nice welcome email to come every time you add a lead to your customer, that is something you could easily do. We have a couple of different welcome options. So if we hit the eyeball on one of them, it actually will kind of show you what the specific template looks like. I like the first one at the top of the screen. So I hit our eyeball, it's gonna auto-populate all of this. And it does say purchase, but it is free. All that purchase is gonna do is take it from your Leap library and push it over to your custom tab library. If you wanna tweak that template, you can see the welcome one is now at the top of the screen. We have a lovely pencil right here, where it actually will pull up that email template we just copied over. And we have our blue edit button at the top right. You're then able to come in here and change the font, change the text size, change the text color, whatever you would like. You have the ability to make any changes. Now, in terms of email automations, one of my favorite features that Leap CRM offers, it is a two-step process to make sure you activate it correctly. So first, you want to turn on what stage you want an automatic email to trigger. Just want to remember this term, guys. It's called workflow automation. You can see it right here, workflow automation. You want to turn on the stage that you want an automatic email to trigger. So in the lead stage here, there's a button that says workflow automation. Enable email, you'd want to make sure it's turned on with a little checkbox. When a stage is enabled for any of these automations, it will actually turn green. The word workflow automation will turn green. If it was off, it is gray. So that is your first indicator to make sure you turn it on the stage level. Step two, you see you have a little arrow up here. It's actually going back to the email template. And tying the specific template to we call the stage. So you wanna turn it on the stage level first, and then step two would be going to the email template, hitting our pencil, and actually linking that specific email template to a stage. So this is the step two. Now you're able to choose a recipient of exactly who you want to get that email when it is triggered. So if I want someone being the customer, every time a lead comes in to get this nice welcome email, that is something you can easily do. If I want attachment to go with it as well, I can attach files. And then all you would have to do is this. Now, there was a question I was posed earlier, a way to communicate to your customer if an appointment comes in. A lot of ways people do that as in customers is they actually have an appointment email that goes out to the customer. So the nice thing about our email templates actually, I'll make one live with you guys. You guys can see the process. It's pretty simple. We're going to add a template. We're going to hit create. And all I'm going to do is put a header here. It's going to auto-populate this customer information and then a text box. Inside our text box, I can say, I, and do you see this little button here? I call them Stat Can the Tuna, but it's called the database elements. This is where you can automate any information for the customer or the job inside of you. So I want the customer's full name to auto-populate when I use this email template. All I do is hit this checkbox. Then it knows anytime this email template comes up, it's gonna pull that customer's name. So I can say, you have an appointment, set. Forward, same idea, but now we're gonna go to the job and specifically the appointment start date. So as long as I made an appointment and I tell my email template I wanna pull that information in here, the system can automatically take that information and put it inside your email when it's true. And I can hit save. Very basic email template, but the idea is the same. Images, attachments. You can do this appointment reminder. Title is internal to you. So when you activate your email templates, see the titles. Email subject is a subject the customer sees or you send it to when they receive that email. If I wanted to link it to the stage, same process. And if I want to go to customer, customer. So we can see it, it's linked right here. Now, if I easily want to get back into my job, recents button, right here, it's at the top of the screen. So that was the last job I was in. And boom, I'm right back. So we're going to put this back into lead. And I'm going to now move the job to appointment assigned. This here is saying, hey, you have an automatic automation. Do you want to ignore it altogether? Or do you want the pop-up to continue showing you what your automations you have set? If I hit yes, it's now opening any emails I have associated. There's a couple ones we've made. This is the one I just made up right here. It has a customer's email address. I hit our pencil. You can see right here. If you wanted to edit it, you hit the pencil. If you don't want to send it, you can uncheck it and it won't send at all. If you want to repeat the email, meaning that it's consistently going to send whatever occurrence you decide to set, that is something you can do. Repeating emails only work with automations. I want something to recur, it has to be an automation where you get this option. Beauty about this though, is I can have something recur, like if you have a collection stage, and you wanna keep sending the customer a collection reminder, it will keep sending until you change stages if you tell it to do that. You say, hey, it ends on the completion of that stage. That is a common thing a lot of clients do. I would highly recommend that as well. Appointment reminders, it's used a lot. The customer webpage, you can use email templates as well. So the idea is just automating your communication with the customer. So for the customer webpage example, if you have an awarded job, when I move the job to awarded, I can have the customer webpage automatically go out to the customer with the link to their live webpage. But that's pretty much it for email templates, automations, and manually using it. Fairly simple, but the most important thing is setting it up on the back end. If it's not set up correctly on the back end, you cannot use it on the front end. And that's about it. Up to you, Melissa.
Amazing. Well, thank you guys so much. We did have a few questions come in. So one that we got during, I believe it was during Veronica's part, so for Sales Pro, was can we do appointment push notifications to the, actually it was sleep. Can we do appointment push notifications to the customer from Armando?
I'm unmuting and I apologize. So for live push notifications, since the customer, like your guy's customer, does not have the Leap app, you have two options. One is if you do use Google Calendar, I'm gonna share my screen again. If you do use Google Calendar, just waiting for it to pop up, sorry about that. When an appointment is made, down here where it says additional recipients, and it's defaulting the customer email address, what that will do is send the customer a Google Calendar invitation to the upcoming appointment. But it only works if you have Google Calendar. Many hit save, the customer gets like an invite through Google to the upcoming appointment. If you do not have Google Calendar, you have to use the email automations like I just showed when you move the job and then emails the customer all the appointments. Those are the two options you have.
This is related. Gina just had a question come in. Is there any plan to expand that to Outlook Calendar? I don't believe we have it currently.
Great question. As of now, no. I actually did have a meeting with our product team on bringing Outlook in. They're investigating the process that they're doing right now. But as of right now, no. But they are looking into keeping the capability for Outlook.
Yeah. Yeah. And please continue to send us recommendations for stuff. That's how we know what to build on the product team.
Yes.
And while we're in Leap, I think it'd be great. Anonymous attendee asked, what is the customer page?
Got it. I can show you that fairly quick. So this is one of the features I do think a lot of clients should start implementing. It's one of my favorite features we offer. Each job, you're going to start from when in doubt, plus it out, as something called the customer webpage. This is always running behind the scene, even if you choose to use it or not use it. Viewing the webpage like this will actually show you information pertaining to your job, any proposals you choose to share, any documents you choose to share, and the pricing of the job. So I wanted the customer to actually see that proposal that came from Sales Pro. I could actually go to my proposal, going back to it here. And you see the three dots right here? Or right clicking, there's a button down here that says show on customer webpage. It's gonna ask me, hey, just add it to the webpage, hit proceed. You get a lovely checkbox, which is telling you, hey, this means it's on the webpage. And if you refresh, it does update in live time. So we can see it right here. This is that same that we got from Sales Pro. These videos are associated to the trade of the job. So for roofing, I can have certain videos. For gutters, I can have certain videos. This is set up on the settings end. Pictures, if there's pictures I put on the job in my CRM, I can choose which specific pictures show on the portal. It works the same way like the proposal. So I'm going to go my when in doubt, plus it out, my 10th time saying it, show the importance. We're going to go to photos and documents. I'm going to go to photos. I'm going to go to, let's do after. I'm going to hit new file. I'm going to browse. On my desktop here. Actually, I think it's in my documents. Here we go, pictures. I have pictures of roof repairs. Don't ask me why, but they just sit on my computer. So it's gonna actually upload these pictures into our CRM. Because these pictures have now been added to this job, that does not mean it's automatically on the web page. I have to choose which picture I want on the web page, just like I did for the proposal. As we can imagine, in real time, it will populate right here. You can have as many images as you want, as many proposals and documents as you want, and all this. The job is scheduled, the pool's here, and all that stuff. Remember, guys, the webpage is optional. Every account that signs up with Leap CRM has it. It is up to you guys to use. I would recommend automating the process. When it hits job awarded, you get the pop-up. Then it's up to you to decide if you actually want to share it with the customer or not. Is there a way to deactivate the web page after it's been shared? Technically, yes. You do have to archive the job for that to happen. So if I do go to here and I archive the job, one of the options is going to ask you, do you still want the web page to be active? And then if you go like this, it won't work anymore. Videos, we don't offer on the CRM for now because it slows down your server a lot. It is something we've looked into. You would have to just put a YouTube.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. Could we just use a YouTube link that you could add on there?
And I'm going to answer the last question on the system template. That is in settings. So if we actually now go to the email templates, it does say system now. I got my dev team to put system. On it. Depending on how many email templates you have in your account, you just might have to find it, but it's actually right here. It says system. This is the one that always pop up. You can't delete it. I took that away from you guys, so you can't mistakenly delete it. But here's the one that you guys are all used to seeing that goes out to your customer. You can edit this now. And the last question, archiving, all it does is hide it. Just hides the job. Imagine putting it in a file folder so you don't see it on your pipeline anymore, but it does still exist.
And then there was a question from Lisa. Can you see if the customer has read your email?
Great question. As of now, no. You can only see if they viewed your proposal by pressing the link. You can't see if they actually have read your email. It is something I did put in the future request list as of now. I just have to check to see exactly where that stands.
Yeah, one way that you could do that is if you use a trackable link like a Bitly or whatever system you prefer to use, you can have tracking links that way just to see if they have clicked it. Another question related to the customer webpage before we move on from there is what happens if a customer clicks on the contact us or issues on the top right corner?
Great question. I did not see that. Good eyes, Melissa. This will send the owner admin of the account an email. This doesn't actually post anywhere. This just sends the owner admin an email of whatever was typed. Now, you guys can actually see there's a lead review link here. This is if you decide to link your Google review to this customer webpage, if they press it, they can leave a Google review. If you decide to link it, this is optional, along with your social links that go to Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, optional.
Yep, so those won't come to us, they will go to you all.
These owner admin, this will post to your Google if you decide to give the customer that ability.
Awesome. All right, and so we do have some Sales Pro questions as well, and if there are more Leap questions, feel free to add those as well, but we'll pester Veronica now. So a question from Megan was, if you use Sales Pro to make a proposal or contract, and you are not with the client, can you still email it to get the signatures?
That's a great question. So we do have something called remote signatures with Sales Pro. You can either use Leap Secure Sign or DocuSign with that feature. So if you're using Leap Secure Sign, you don't need anything extra. You can just switch over to remote signature and you can send it that way. So let me pull up my iPad screen right here and I'll go ahead and give you a quick preview of what that looks like. So here I am. I'm back inside that document that I was using earlier. And this time when I click to sign, instead of being on the live signature tab, which is for when you're in person, face to face, and you want them to sign using their finger right on the iPad, I can instead switch over to remote signature. From here, I can either select Ronnie's email address, or I can even use the little keyboard here to type it in. We also have an option to send this via text message as well. But once this is filled out, and let me go ahead and put my signature in there. Now I can go ahead and send it, and that'll send it to Ronnie, and he'll be able to pull it up on his computer and sign it remotely.
Great. All right. And then I think this may be another one where you'll be sharing your screen, but Brandon asked, how do you access Sales Pro from JP or from Leap?
Ooh, that's a great question. And I'm sorry, my puppy's barking. So I hope she's not too loud, but
working from home.
I know, right? I really apologize about that. But in order to access Sales Pro from the Leap CRM, you will need to have a Sales Pro account. So if you are interested in that and you don't have a Sales Pro account just yet, feel free to reach out to us. We can have our sales team demo it to you. But once you have your account, all you have to do is download the app onto your iPad, and then you'll sign in using your username and password. So it is a separate product. You do need a separate account for it.
Yes, and someone asked, is Sales Pro only for iPad tablet use? It is only iPad or iOS. You can use it on your phone as well, and on a computer for the main admin dashboard. Okay. I think that's all of the questions that came through. If not, please share them again real quickly. And before we sign off, just wanted to let everyone know we will be sending out the recording of this. You guys have been amazing with the questions. And of course, Ronnie and Veronica have shared so much. I'm sure going back and watching the recording will be very valuable. So once you get that, we will also be sending some resources along with it to help really reinforce what we've learned today. And yeah, thank you guys again. And be on the lookout for that in your inbox very soon. All right. Thank you guys.
Thanks, everybody. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.